Now I'd like to go into a little detail concerning the preferences that we previously created. These are the work path, meaning the project folder that EDIUS is using, and the project presets. The work path was created in the correct place upon the first start of EDIUS. When someone has by accident created a misnamed folder or has chosen the wrong folder, they may need to change it at a later date. And as the greeting window in which we set the path only appears upon the first start of EDIUS, the only way to change the path is by going directly into the settings. The settings are found here in the menu Settings, and the work path can be found in the User Settings menu. There are a multitude of possible settings here that we do not need to deal with in the scope of this quick tutorial, as most settings are set up correctly for a basic start. What does interest us, however, is here in the Application section under Project File, and here in the first field we can see the path we specified when starting EDIUS for the first time. If I wished to change this path, then I would do so by selecting a new path by clicking on the Browse tab. Here I can also specify which standard name EDIUS suggests when a new project is created. If I was to change the name here, then the new name would be the name first suggested to me by EDIUS. As my work path is correct, I will click OK to leave this window without changing anything. The next thing relevant to the settings that I would like to show is also in the Settings menu, but this time under System Settings. There, under Application Project Presets, I can see the project presets created when we first started EDIUS. If I made errors previously, or if presets are missing which I would like to use, I can at any moment create new presets by clicking the New Preset button or by using the preset wizard that we know from the EDIUS Start section, and I can then use them in my project. So that ends our small explanation about those settings. Click here for the next video. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. And this playlist contains the complete EDIUS tutorial.